Well, he and his two lawyers were very bright and so I said, I have an enemy judging by your phone call earlier this evening. He said, yes, we have just gotten from our informal conference with the U.S. attorney. He proceeded then to voluntarily give me his whole testimony.
Now, it involved other things besides tax and
said, in all honesty, this was a kind of a non-decision. Nobody was going to comprehend this thing. But we were sort of bulldozed into it. I hope that's the end of this. Do as Liddy's project. I said, well, now, clear up on just how well informed was Strahan. He said, I informed him orally of it. He had the budget. The budget was very expensive. Okay. Marcus was started to come out of that thing with one. We got synopses of the law. He said, I got the only copy. I agree. That's the only copy of the synopses. Not to mention the copy. There were a lot of them, too. The one copy that Magruder had pictures of the kinds of papers that you would find around the campaign. The synopsis of the pictures we mentioned. He thought it was so bad he picked up the phone and called it in and chewed it out. He called it shit. I told Strahan the synopses were here. He may have come over and pressed him on that. He got less than I'm sure of that. I saw three synopses and they were, we had them. Now I'm going to skip back away and then I'll come back to the potential. You sure you think that one is strong? Back in March, about the time of the meeting that he was getting, he threatened the Magruder's life. He said he was transferred to the stance operation. LaRue approached Magruder and said, we need that operation. You ought to take it back. Come back from the White House to the headquarters, he says, he told the U.S. Attorney, and visited, and they needed the operation. Back to the quality of the work. What they were getting was mostly this fellow Oliver pointing his girlfriends all over the country, lining up assignations. And we didn't like it, and discussing their young leaders' conference. Liddy was badly embarrassed by the showing out of that. Said the gentleman to Mr. Mitchell, I'll take care of it. And we called it a center. So the next week, when you're trying to get Liddy's own phone, the jury says neither Mitchell nor Magruder knew there was another way to get this confirmation. I said, what? After the firing of Liddy, Magruder was very nervous about that. He called John D. and asked me to talk to Liddy. So that because he was acting direct. Who in the White House is involved in this whole thing? One of the names that I give, Dick Howard, some of the closest people, and a lot of the secretaries in the EOD have various information about a lot of different projects and tickets, all kinds of things. Will come for it after the process of this whole thing. No, I said, back to murder, who else? He said, no one else. He said, the U.S. Attorney is hot after cold. They know he was supposed to hunt. The only thing they have him on right now is a phone call with Magruder, so far as Jeb knows. But his attorney then chimed in and said, I think the U.S. Attorney has a good lawyer. Because the U.S. Attorney told the lawyer that Hunt had re-perjured himself with respect to Colson when he was called back in under the testifying and testified the break-in and the capture of the murderer in the cover-up. Mitchell, LaRue, Martin, and the lawyers basically lost the group. Dean devised a cover story of the concert with these other people. And they listed Mark Porter, who went to the grand jury and perjured himself Dean prepared Magruder and others for their testimony in the grand jury cross-examining them, giving them rhetoric. Likewise, he leaked out information from the grand jury to the people of the committee for the re-election. And they knows that he did that, he knew he would do so. They knew where he got it, and he got it from a higher up. Yes, sir. Then he took him back.
Madam.
There's $1.5 million in cash that was distributed.
Jeez.
LaRue and his fans know about it. There's, quote, the famous list, unquote, of where that money went. I don't know. I'm going to have to check my notes with Brian. Brian may have told me about that. They gave me some idea where that went. Mitchell said that we're going to talk. He's very cheap. Haldeman. Haldeman is very much a target of the U.S. attorney. So far, they indicated that he was implicated only by association with other people. And he's wrong. The attorney gave me his private evaluation that was a little public on the part of the U.S. attorney. He did not think that they reasoned or Kyle Moore is somebody on the staff who was at the committee, and who accompanied Liddy on what are called the Saturday events. The Saturday events are the events that took place the day after the murder. Liddy went out to find these for Jerry and Judy, and they had to let everybody on jail on murders and John Mitchell. And LaRue, of course, and Marty, and largely on construction. There are no many accounts for obstruction of justice. One of the attorneys that winding up, I told him, they gave Jeb your wishes and solicitations of penalties and so on. And one of the attorneys said, well, you know, in all of this, there is no scintilla that the president was in any way aware of any of these transactions. And he said, well, I didn't say that for any purpose except just to express the impression I had about the way this thing's going. There are literally tens of dozens of people down there applying to be heard now by the U.S. attorney. So he said, this thing is rapidly deteriorating. But he said, in all of this, I don't see any evidence of the involvement. So that was that. Thank you. Something on the way. Now, I have the Attorney General of the United States sitting at home ready to go to this dinner party. And I have the Deputy Attorney General out of town. But as Bob points out, there isn't anything in my report that is pretty well covered and expanded on in what they've just gotten from the group. So I think what I can do is call the Attorney General, tell him what I was going to tell him. Tell him that Magruder has just disclosed to me what he has shown the U.S. Attorney, and that I really don't have anything to add. But I did want him to be aware of the fact of the work that was done and what I have done today. And I think it was loose at that you have to make sure that Magruder tried to purpose your meeting was to make the point that they should not want to cripple a misguided assumption of others to the president's right. This doesn't touch me, he was in evidence that existed and all that. Oh, yes, Bob.
I thought it was talking about Strahan. Strahan said he did not know about it.
He was trying to report it. He's
your view about
it. Heard it. I don't know. No, I don't think they had that. That's why he's wearing that clothes to be injured Monday morning. That's why it's occurred to be given this information so he doesn't bring it himself.
Right.
I don't think he's testified on any of this, so I don't think he has any burden problem. What he's got to do is build an event that meets these points, and he can keep himself as an office boy, which is what he was. He's not an office boy. He lied by the thing, he persuaded Gordon to keep Liddy on, I would think he would argue that. Said to me, no, what should we do? And I said, please, I think we've got to keep him on. He's getting this gun. And I would never resign. And I think Gordon doesn't know how to deal with that if you give it to him. But now I went back to Gordon today on his point of view. And he said, absolutely. There was no other money. With God, the 22 was for a fellow man like that, according to what Howard told him. I see what you're talking about.
Right.
Well, we got Magruder now. He missed payroll. He's still on the government payroll. I think it's the second time around on the payroll. I'm concerned, sir. He got down to the legal security. What's the purpose of?
The purpose of getting her to raise the money.
What's the purpose of paying the debts?
The purpose of keeping them pulled on the reservation.
Right.
What was that?
Thank you, sir.